Good morning. Good morning and welcome on this Palm Sunday. It's the last Sunday in Lent. And it is a joyous Sunday. The anticipation of Easter, the anticipation of the resurrection of Christ, his triumphant victory over death and overcoming of all that is darkness in the world. Palm Sunday has been imaged many times in art. Jesus' wonderful entry into Jerusalem, all the crowds gathering to see him, wanting to touch him, wanting to follow him, wanting to greet him. So let us celebrate this Sunday with that sense of joy and of welcome, knowing that we are embraced by Christ, by his power and hope. Wherever we are, it gives us strength. As you know, we have made Psalm 23 the theme for our short sermons this Lent. Today we will reflect on the final verse 6 of this beloved Psalm. The watchword for this week is from St. John in the 3rd chapter. So must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. We begin our service in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The epistle reading for this Sunday is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of the Father. Word of God, word of life.
The Gospel for this Sunday is from St. John, chapter 12. The next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it, as it is written, "Do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt." His disciples did not understand these things at first, but then Jesus was glorified. Then they remembered that these things had been written of him and had been done to him. So the crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead continued to testify. It was also because they heard that he had performed this sign that the crowd went to meet him. The Pharisees then said to one another, "You see, you could do nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." This is the Gospel of Jesus Christ.
Good
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. This is the closing verse of Psalm 23, the most well-known of all 150 Psalms contained in the Hebrew Bible. It is a verse which sums up God's relationship with us and our relationship with God. We live in God's house. We live in this house as a family, looked after, guided, and sustained by God. God who treats us with mercy and goodness. This is not only about how God treats us, but who God is. God is love, and love includes and is made visible through goodness and mercy. In Psalm 23, we are promised that even though we walk through the darkest valleys, we have to fear no evil. For God, our shepherd, is with us, comforting us, holding us in the palm of God's hands. Psalm 23 is stunningly beautiful in what it says, in its simplicity, and in its complete trust, the image of shepherd and sheep. Yet, are there not many moments in our lives when we feel God to be absent? When we feel alone, forsaken, deeply depressed in the valley of our tears, of our sufferings? There is no doubt those moments happen. They are real, and sometimes they are not just moments. They can be years, even, of deep struggle through ill health, poverty, emotional, psychological, and physical abuse, modern-day slavery, discrimination of all kinds, and being refugees. Today we celebrate Palm Sunday, Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, the big welcome he got. And yet, only 5 days in 5 days' time, we will remember Jesus, the Son of God, the Son of Man, on the cross. Jesus crying out on the cross to his Abba Father God, Lema sabachthani, why have you forsaken me? That moment of Jesus' experience of God-forsakenness on the cross is one of the most central keys to our faith. Because this moment was not only a moment of deepest, cruelest suffering, the moment of experience of God-forsakenness in Jesus' life, but it foreshadows Easter, the resurrection, eternal life in the eternal house of God that is promised to us all. But this house, God's house, is not just promised to us in the future. We already live in God's house of mercy and goodness in the here and now. It is not an empty promise. And it is precisely the experience and the manifestation of goodness and mercy that build and make up this house. Goodness and mercy pull us out of our sufferings. They help us to renew, to be sustained, and to live in hope and in trust wherever we find ourselves. The real challenge to every one of us throughout our lives is not to give up, not to fall into despair. And it is far more easily said than done. Even Jesus cried out to his Father. Even Jesus had the experience of being forsaken. We only know too well that there are billions of people in the world whose sufferings are so great, so overwhelming and long-lasting that they may easily fall into despair. People in that situation need mercy and goodness. And here mercy and goodness become very concrete realities. It's really important to realize that goodness and mercy and the image of the house of God are not just spiritual ideas, but concrete realities. Every act of goodness, every act of mercy contributes to building the house of God, the house of love, of neighbor as ourselves. Nursing, medics, social work, free food and clothes distribution, NGOs, teaching, truthful journalism, police, fire brigades, volunteering, signing petitions of aid and justice organizations, social and climate activism, demonstrations against political extremism and for climate justice. All of these are professions, institutions, and actions that are guided by goodness, mercy, kindness, law, justice, equality, and love. All of these are evidence of the Spirit of God in the widest sense, whether carried out by those who are members of a church, Christian believers, of any religion, or simply those who follow their innate sense of goodness. While evil is all around us, goodness is also all around us. In every little kind gesture, in every phone call in which we connect with people who we love or we need or who need our help, in every smile when we pass someone on our daily walk. So yes, despite all that befalls us, all that happens to us, all that we have to endure in our lives, there always also is goodness, mercy, friendship, and love. We just have to look out for it and act accordingly in whatever way that is possible for us. God reveals God's self in many ways, and in a very concrete way through us, through the human being concerned for the other, for the neighbor, near and far. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord our whole life long. Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious God, at this time when so much uncertainty has beset us all, we are gathered in your name. During Holy Week, we look to you. We hear your word and focus our hope on you. You stand beside those who are in deep worry, those who are suffering and dying, those who find it difficult to keep hope. You are with all who care and save lives. You hold those who do not know how to confront their loneliness and their existential fears. Be with all who this week gather in your name, who call on you, trusting that you know our need and are with us in our affliction. Bless every community under your word and sacrament, and all people who gather before your cross, alone or in community. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
As we go into Holy Week, let us trust that God, the Good Shepherd, in Jesus Christ, is with us, amongst us, and will hold us, whoever and wherever we are. Children, women, and men, of any sexual orientation, black or white, rich or poor, in grief or in joy. God, who is love, bless you and keep you. God's face shine on you and be gracious to you. God look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen.